everyone, welcome back to my channel. So first of all, I would like to wish you a very very happy Durga Puja to you all. So in this tutorial, I'm making this macrame shelf and I'm using the same knot, which is the square knot, to make this entire shelf. I have already made a flower hanger by using the same knot. If you have not seen that video or if you have not understand any step from this video, you can always go and watch that other video. I'll link that video on this I button over there. So let's go and start with this video. We will need a macrame thread. I'm using the cotton one here. Measured a cord of around 90 inches long. We need 18 of them, or you can take more if you want. We also need 6 little longer cord of about 100 inches long. I'm taking this wooden stick, tie a rope on both sides of the stick so that we can easily hang it somewhere. Then start attaching the 18 cords one by one like so. Take 4 cords from the sides and make a square knot. Make a L shape with the left cord and pass the right cord through it, keeping the other 2 cords on the middle. Then just do the opposite, like make the L with the right cord and then pass the left cord through. Now you have to continue this process throughout the other cords till the end of the row. For the next row, make a square knot in between the knots from the upper row and leave 2 cords free in the front. So basically you have to decrease one knot every time. So keep going like this until you have only one knot left. From here, we are going to do just opposite of the decreasing pattern. Here we are increasing one knot every time. After you are done, just do the decreasing pattern once again. Now we have this extra 6 cords, so start attaching them with the pattern, 3 cords each side. Take one part from each 3 cords and start forming a braid the same way like we used to do in our hair. Do it till the bottom part of the pattern and secure it with a cello tape. Do the same with the other cords as well and also on the other side. So it will look something like this. The front brace should be little longer than the back one. I also put a cello tape on the bottom. Let's make the plate now. I'm taking this wooden plate with four holes on the corner. On this plate, I am going to apply this wood stain which I brought from itsybitsy.com. You can apply this with the help of a sponge or a brush or even with a cloth. I'm wearing a glove before doing so because I don't want any stain on my hand. Start applying the color nicely on the whole plate. I'll link every product that I'm using on the description below. After everything is covered, I'm taking the stencil paper, place it on the middle, and with the help of this texture paste, start pasting the texture on the plate. You can also apply any color instead of this paste. Then I also did a half pattern on the sides, and this is how it will look in the end. Lastly, I'm also applying varnish on the top. Then attach this plate with the help of these braids on the sides. Pass one braid through one hole and tie a knot on the bottom. This part might be a little tricky. You have to be really, really careful and patient. Do the same with the others too. Trim the cords from the bottom, and this is how it will look in the end. Thank you for watching my video till the end. I hope you liked it, and if you do, please give it a big thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe my channel. So see you again next week. Bye bye.